Herzlich willkommen, Salve TV begrüßt mit einer weiteren Sendung bei unserer beliebten Serie Weltgeist auf Sendung. Vielleicht auch bei der nicht minder beliebten Serie Wege der Heilkunst. Und wir sind froh und glücklich, heute Professor Jonathan de Vierville bei uns zu haben. Einen amerikanischen Gast, der viel in dieser Region schon gemacht hat und besucht hat. Er hat jungianische Psychotherapie studiert, praktiziert. Er ist Massagetherapeut. Er hat ein Spa in San Antonio, Texas. Er unterrichtet an der San Antonio University. Und er hat so viele Eigenschaften, dass es besser ist, wir fragen ihn selber nach weiteren seiner tollen Eigenschaften. Und dieses tun wir, weil er Englisch spricht, auf Englisch. Und deswegen schalten wir jetzt von der wunderschönen deutschen Sprache auf die wunderschöne englische Sprache um. I welcome you, Jonathan de Vierville, and so I'd like to ask you to add in your language what I've missed out in my German introduction.
Well, in the workshop that we just did is called Spa Cultures, Dreams and Healing Waters. And so what we're looking at is the origins of spa culture, which in the ancient world were dream healing temples, Asclepius and Asclepium, and different ancient rites and rituals and a process that really taps into the unconscious, that the origins of psychotherapy are in the dream world. And so what we're doing here is going through a similar type of process and tapping into the unconscious and having the participants look at what goes on with their dreams. It's a process of dream incubation. And it's a very, not just a therapeutic method, but it's also a recreative method. Out of it has come the Wet Poetry Society. And so it's a variety of things that help facilitate not only personal issues, but also cultural issues. We're talking about different things that are going on in the world, and that becomes all part of this process. And of course, the warm healing waters at Bad Salza help to facilitate this very well.
Well, thank you. In a nutshell, we learned so much more about what connects you to Bad Salza and Weimar, the broad range of what your themes are. And I think really what strikes out is the connection that is intuitively very clear to many people, that there is a connection between dreams and water. That is kind of at the core of the workshop that we just had. Maybe from your Jungian and Greek philosophy's point of view, and from your contemporary practice, how would you see, can we look at that connection between dreams and water?
Well, in terms of water and dreams and water, the whole idea, I mean, we are water, but also central to spa, salut per aqua, many spargare, different renditions of what spa means, is water. And so central to spa culture is how we observe, how we use water ritually in terms of purification, be it sauna, sweat, bathing. And so part of the whole process is the preparing one, vacating, in other words, preparing one for the dreaming, in other words, like sleep. I mean, and in a sense, from a symbolic point of view, water is kind of, would be a symbol, say, of the unconscious. So you're floating, you're cleansing, you're opening yourself up to the wonders of the psyche, the wonders of the soul, in a sense, or the wonders of the unconscious and the images that come up as you float and as you are open to one's dreams in the night.
So from what you say and what I've observed you do over the years, it seems you make it a very you make it an important point that the European tradition of using water in dreams maybe 2,000 years ago was much more profound, much more developed than it is now, and that there is good reason to reconnect with that ancient knowledge, particularly that was there in Greek times, historic Greek times. So how do we make this connection? Rekindling a sense of ritual and water and bring this in modern times. What are the best suggestions to do this?
Well, in terms of the mantra is the deeper the memory, the further the vision. And again, if one goes back into deep memory, both personal memories, one has memories and one's own memories, but we're also, what we're exploring now are the cultural memories in terms of what's going on in terms of our culture. So part of that is the formulation of a question or some issues, and so we're actually putting out conscious questions, conscious issues, things that are concerning us in terms of life, work, different issues, and then putting these questions, you might say, into the water, you know, or putting them out, and then watching over the week as to how the dreams respond to these questions. And it's quite amazing to watch the psyche, the soul, respond to these. And it's not just an analytical, but it's also a creative and an associative process. People and its feelings are involved, and deep ideas. And so there are a lot of unexpected turns and twists, and it's kind of like dancing in many ways. But and it's a creative process that one leaves oneself open to the mystery.
Well, leaving ourselves open to the mystery is a wonderful invitation, and I think what you also mentioned is really key to the success, to consider this as a group activity. People are much closer to themselves, to their own unconscious, to the unconscious of the other when they're in the water. And of course, in dreams, there is no boundary between what is my imagination and what's the Weltgeist. And I think it's very important to have a system or protocol to really enter that space as a communal space. And from what I've seen in your work, it's very important that people dream in their own subconscious, dream and bathe in their own space, but then share what they found and then see what is important in my dream may be also equally important to the dream of the other, and so that the dream work is a currency of communal understanding. Is that what the Weltgeist does?
In the sense of the matrix or the field, the dream field, it becomes a dream field. Some people have aspects of their dreams that seem to connect with others. But what is particularly important and what is very appropriate for this place in the world, Weimar and Thuringia, is the recent archaeological discoveries. And what we're doing here is not only are we bathing and floating in space and water, but we're also visiting the planetariums and looking at dreams from a not only a personal but also a cosmological point of view. We're visiting Nebra as well as Gosek. In other words, we're going back in time, and so we're allowing to really look at deep time, deep space in this. So it is, part of this whole process is a deep perspective. I joke in the sense I call it, you know, the cosmological imperative, but there is something about where humanity is at now in this stage of its history. Sitting here in Weimar and hearing in Jena and Hegel and all of the spirit that is here in this part of the world in German history and philosophy, there's something that is moving and that is very alive here, and it just seems this has kind of come together in the last few years, and so we're actually kind of allowing the process to unfold and lead us, and it's fun, but very informative. I mean, the people that participate walk away with a new sense of wonder.